think if God existed, he could do it? The answer is no! If God exists, it's fucking me!
So, I did do this intro already, but the fucking mic is being stupid. Guess they were supposed to be back there, but I didn't, because I got home. I was fucking exhausted. Why? Because I didn't realize it was a 4-hour drive there and back. It was supposed to be like 2.5 at the most. But traffic, boom. Construction, boom. But I did learn that I'm like so close to throwing a full again. And they're about to start working with me to throw layouts, which I've never done on purpose. But since it's back day, we spam shoulders until I physically cannot do it anymore. And we're going to attempt to do these because I don't have a time limit today because it's not even 1 o'clock. I got to force myself to stay up to take my pause to work at 4. So I don't fucking know. We're going to try to keep these going until about 2:30-ish. Get home, eat, relax, take my pause to work, then go to sleep about 4:15-ish. 4:30, wake up at 1, pick him up from work, go to work, rinse and repeat. But tomorrow's fucking leg day. Woohoo. And I'm shitty because I don't usually start the week off with fucking back. I usually start with legs, but the fucking split. I say split. Me driving so much is fucking me up. I be tired as hell when I get home. Like yesterday, I was sleep before 10:30. But hey, fuck it. We're gonna make it work. Whether we gotta lift in the morning or something, we are gonna make it work though. So I think I sat on one of my testicles because my testicle hurts. But this is also like a informative video because one of my friends texted me right after I clocked in at work and was like, hey, show me how to flex my back muscles, this, that, and other. And I told her that I would make a video and send it to her. So once I start flexing or whatever, I am still having my physique for myself, so I'm not going to take my shirt off or anything, but I will go through the motions of showing her how to flex her back and whatnot. And the great part about it is she hit me up on the day that I was going to hit back workouts anyway, so you know it worked out. But I'm gonna fucking spam lat pull downs because I think it's like 1:15 ish right now, so I got over an hour worth of workouts to do. I ain't say over an hour because I don't really need to be home till 3. But I said I'm going to be done before 3 so I can be home and eating by 3. But before that, we're going to chalk up so our hands don't get, I ain't going to say so our hands don't get sweaty, but so when our hands do get sweaty, we don't lose our grip on the fucking bar. God damn. Thank you. I got a fork. But anyways, goddamn. So before I clocked out, I'm not gonna say before I clocked out, but my last set of gifts of the night, some of my riggers, one of them was teaching me new techniques on making drinks. Well, not making drinks, but new techniques to use while I'm making drinks to make it look more theatrical. And the other one was teaching me, well, not teach me, but give me knowledge about weightlifting. Because I was telling him why I don't eat spicy food a lot, because I run. So what I was saying before my camera cut off was, I was telling him why I don't eat spicy food, because I run in the morning and be falling asleep and waking up, taking a shit and then running. My stomach's still gonna be fucking sizzling. And then he started talking about, oh, do you lift this, that, and other? He asked me what my weightlifting goals were. And I told him I wanted to hit 405 on squat. He asked me about bench. I was like, I'm not really worried about benching. I hit 225 and I'm happy with that, because I'm a squat and deadlift specialist, in my opinion. My bench has always been shit. I am working towards it, but I don't have a goal for a bench. So, yeah. My baseline, bare minimum, was 225, and I'm happy with that. But squat and deadlift, they got to go up. He'll give me points at this, that, and the other, but that's pretty much all I had to say before my camera cut off. Let me finish spamming these, and then, shit, I don't know, finish this workout. I ain't got nothing to say, I don't think. Shout out to everybody that went to gym today. And shout out to everybody that went to gym yesterday. And if you didn't go to gym today, shout out to you for getting 3 meals in, I guess. And for drinking more water. But if you didn't go to gym today, go twice as hard tomorrow. I actually lost count and forgot what I was doing. But I think I can up the weight. Man. It feels weird though, like. I'm actually feeling it in the left side of my back now. Let me see if this weight feels good. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Am I going to keep track of what weight this is? Probably not. Am I going to get next time? Yeah. But live, forget, live again, then you learn. So I'll admit, it just took me like 5 minutes to figure out where I want to put my camera, because I need my fucking face in it. But, oh fuck. My right shoulder is killing me today, and I honestly don't know why. I ain't really did much, but shit, fucking lat pull down. I said lat pull down, fucking tricep extension. And I was able to hit the 100 last week, so we're going to attempt to hit it again this week. I don't know what number we're going to... Fuck it, we're just going to go until it hurts. You good. I don't know what number it was. Fuck. Fucking shoulders hurt. Well, not shoulder, shoulder. I don't fucking know why. Because it's not the... It's the back end, though. I might just be sleeping weird on it. We'll figure it out. Alright, so the first set moved way better than I thought it was gonna move. I run back and rewatch the video and I hit 20 easy after struggling with the fucking 80s for so long. So fuck it, man. We gonna push the limits a little bit. And we gonna go, I think we can go to 120 and see if we can push it for 12 easy. Well, I ain't gonna say easy, 12 smooth. I will admit it, I am a little surprised and happy. This 120, I don't want to push and go any higher, because right now I'm only 160. I'm 160. 162 before I went to work, but 160, 165-ish. If I can push my fucking body weight for triceps, I might start feeling myself a little too much. I'm a debate on it. During my rest period, I might flip a coin. I don't need to get too happy today.
Alright, so the highest it goes is 150. So we're gonna use it. But
let's check it. 150. I know you're like, oh, you doing that just so we can see the weight? No, I'm doing it for myself just in case I don't believe it when I wake up in the morning.
How many
are we
here for?
At this point, this video was getting drawn out way longer than I wanted to, but I did say 3 to 6 exercises. It's gonna be 5 exercises because I'm about to do a couple reps of pull-ups to make sure I still got it, and then I'm gonna do some forearm work and call it a night. Woo! That feels weird. I think I overdid it on the fucking tricep pull downs or tricep extensions. My fucking hands are in so much pain. How this week is gonna go, because it's Monday and shit, I want to grab a 25, but I'm not finna go look for one, so I'm gonna grab this 45 and hopefully it works the same. Okay, yeah. So this week we gonna force feed ourselves because I lost weight. I lost weight I didn't want to lose, and I'm not in a cut or a bulk, which is why I'm finna force feed myself. Cause shit, I was 175 when I came home. I've been home for, today would make exactly a month, and I've lost about 12 or 13 pounds. I know people are like, the people around me are saying, oh, you're looking bigger than others. I don't feel bigger. And I feel my energy levels dropping, meaning like I'm not doing well. My face is slimming up. And if I can notice it in my face, but the muscles are looking good, but I don't like the fact that I lost some weight. So we're gonna force ourselves to eat more. And I'm actually set my reminders to tell me when to eat. Oh. Because me losing weight without trying is fucking terrifying. So, But I will say one thing, though. The fact that I'm losing weight and the muscles are looking good and, like, I don't know. Triceps, cool. I'm able to do hammer curls with the 45s without really struggling. So I guess I'm not doing terrible, but I don't want to lose weight. Like, I don't know. I'm not running, so I shouldn't be losing this weight. I want to start back running, but I don't want to start back running while I'm losing weight, because then that means I'm losing more weight. But I might be a little bit more famished, so I'll be forced to eat more. So I don't know. I'll try to do more running over the weekend since I'm not going to be working. Because I can't really do it now because I get off work midnight, 1 o'clock, come in here, work out. Got to be gone by 3:30, drop my pops off at work, and I got to be asleep by 4 so I can get an eight-hour nap, get up, pick him up from work, and get ready to go to work. So I don't know. We're going to figure something out, but it's all life is. It's trial and error and figuring out what you want to do, which is kind of shitty because he's going to have to figure something out, because once my plans get to rolling, I'm not going to be able to pick him up and drop him off at work every day. All right, quick mic check. 2 hours. Haven't seen that in a minute. But doing this for mic check. Let's make sure it's on. All right, so mic check done. Let me speak on this workout right quick, right fast. I actually enjoyed all of it. Can't complain, really. The only thing I would say I could have done different, I could have came in here with a more solid plan. All I knew was it was back day. I had to make up for not coming in yesterday, which
message. I 100% planned on coming to her yesterday, but I got home maybe 8:30, 9 o'clock maybe. I got back in town about 8:45-ish, and my mom called me right before I made it home and was like, hey, stop at Walmart, pick up this and other. Got home about 9:30. I walked around Walmart looking for stuff, and then she called me again and was like, hey, pick this up too.
So, y'all know how that went.
But, yeah, and then I was like, oh, I can go to the gym in my usual time, take me a quick little nap. I did not want to wake up from that nap. I even had two alarms set, cut both of them off.
Snap a new rig, it's not cooperating, but let me go ahead and talk through this.
Back holding for my friend girl. So, from what I've learned, back posing wise, I'm not gonna take my shirt off because I'm trying to keep my physique out of sight, out of mind until July. So, we gotta make sure. Let's see. We did not turn it completely towards the mirror, so we need to put up. Yeah, so flexing the back, we're gonna do double back bicep up, elbows forward, and we're gonna try to drop the elbows down just a little bit. That's gonna flare up the shoulders, the biceps, and the lats also. And you don't have like wrist placement, like most people turn the wrist all the way up, but like I can go. I like to try to bring my wrist forward more so than to my shoulders and try to keep it just a little bit open because, you know, flare out the fucking lats and the shoulders. Triceps, what do I usually do? Well, I say usually because I just started doing this maybe like 2 months ago. Once you get, depending on which side you was, like say you pose your left side, which I'm about to do, you want to get your right hand, you know, like, flat and push your palm into, I'll say, the knuckles of your right hand. And that's how you, like, you push down with your left, push up just a little bit with your right, and it flicks the forearm and the tricep. And, you know, you got to just hit it just right so you can see it and kind of pull your shoulder back, you know. Lat spread, which I cannot do a front lat spread at all, but I can show you what it looks like from the front. Thumbs, because of the how my lats are, I have really, I'll say about medium. I get right under the last rib. I scoop down under it and push up and bring my elbows forward and up just a bit. You know, make sure you breathe, because if you're not breathing, you're gonna fucking pass out. So, scoop under, up, elbows clear, boom. It would look a lot better with no shirt, but I'm not taking shirt off. And let me think. Another one I like to do, which is probably the most simplest one, because you don't even really have to flex. It's called, I think it's the Icarus pose. I'm gonna call it the Icarus pose because that's what I got in my head right now. Whenever I do the pose, I think of Icarus. Basically, just spreading as wide as you can and kind of like keep your elbows a little bit lower. And it technically is a lat spread, but it also is accentuates the shoulders and the traps. And if you want to get really technical, I don't remember the name of this one actually, but you know, boom, activate the traps, shoulders, and just extend. Basically, make sure you hit it low though, so like you can get everything. And I see most people, they spread wide so they can get down in there. And then we also got the Archer pose, which I do a lot because it looks fucking amazing. Left arm, or it doesn't matter which arm, extends, like, and it's called the Archer pose. My camera cut off, but it's called Archer pose. So do it like you about to do archery, if you ever done archery. If not, look up a video, cause I don't have the space on my phone to explain. Point, boom, hold, engage, and pull this one, and hold it, basically.